What's up guys, this is Balázs from Racing Brick. You know this LEGO Technic hub well from the Control Plus sets, and you know that it requires batteries, a lot of them. I don't like to use alkaline batteries, I prefer rechargeable ones instead, but you need to take them out for charging, which is not very convenient, and the voltage is lower compared to the alkalines, at least on paper, but more about this later. LEGO used to have a rechargeable battery box for the power function system, although it was pretty expensive and it had a proprietary charger that was even more expensive. They even make a rechargeable battery for some other hubs in the powered up ecosystem, like the one for Spike Prime or the Mindstorms hub. Since the Technic hub has a removable battery compartment, it would be a pretty straightforward move to produce a rechargeable unit that fits in the same slot. Unfortunately, LEGO does not offer anything similar yet. So, here comes a solution from Phondly. This is their rechargeable EnBo battery pack designed for the Technic hub. This is a prototype unit with a high-quality 3D printed enclosure. The final product is planned to have an injection-molded ABS enclosure. Phondly is launching a Kickstarter campaign for the product. Their page should be already live by now. You can find the link at the usual places. Meanwhile, we can check the official website at phondly.com. As you can see, I have two different covers here, one for the original version of the Technic hub that has the snap-on lid, and one for the new type that has the lid with the screws. The battery fits in both types with the two different covers. So, let's see what it can do exactly. First of all, it has a USB-C charging port with 2 amps fast charging. There's an LED light in the logo that lights up during charging and goes off when it is finished. Due to the placement of the port, you don't need to take the battery out during the charging process, that is very convenient. And here's another cool extra, you can actually connect a power bank to the battery and increase its capacity on the go. This obviously depends on the placement of the hub, as it won't work for example with this buggy, but if you design your custom creation with this in mind or you try with another stock set like this one, it works like a charm. Talking about the capacity, the included batteries are 2040 mAh cells with a total capacity of 14.6 Wh. There's a built-in battery protection for overcharge, over-discharge and overcurrent. I did not do measurements or statistics because someone already did it who is way more capable than me. I'm sure you know Philo and his excellent webpage with tons of information about anything related to LEGO electronics. He has a great article about this battery with lots of measurements and tests. He built a cool contraption to stress test the different batteries. This one is the most interesting for me, the battery voltage graphs. The red line is the battery by Phondly, the purple line is Philo's DIY LiPo battery with 2 cells, the green one represents the rechargeable IKEA LADA batteries that I also use, and the blue ones are regular alkaline batteries. People often say that the alkalines are way better than the rechargeable AA or AAA batteries because 1.5 volts is much more than 1.2 volts. Well, yes, on paper, but as you can see the proof here, alkalines only provide 9 volts when they are brand new, and the voltage drops quickly. If we compare the IKEA rechargeables to this, on paper they are supposed to start at 7.2 volts, but it's actually close to 8.5, and they overperform the alkalines quickly while staying above the nominal voltage for a long time. With lower voltage you get slower and slower motor speeds, I think that's pretty clear. How about the Phondly battery? Well, it is playing in a completely different league. Rock steady 9 volts until it lasts. As Philo wrote here, the prototype unit he got did shut down without any particular warning or a sign of being drained. This will change in the final version. If the internal voltage drops below a certain degree, it switches to that output, showing a low battery warning in the app itself and with a visible change in output power. So, here you can see a few tests with some LEGO sets, showing the speed and power difference with the different battery types. About the pricing, I don't have the final details yet, but the baseline price is expected to be around 75 euros, but there will be some cool discounts with the different pledge levels on Kickstarter. I suggest to check out the page for the details. So, is it worth the price? Well, it really depends on your needs. 6 rechargeable batteries with a basic charger from IKEA cost around 20 euros, so that's definitely much cheaper. And as a big plus, they can be used in other toys or home appliances. But at the same time with this thing you get a fixed 9 volt output, so no change in speed or power during the entire playtime. There's the convenience of direct USB charging without the need of removing the battery at all, a possibility to use a power bank for a quick recharge or to extend the capacity, and even the weight is reduced compared to the standard AA solutions. I think these are some great advantages, so if you need these, then I really suggest to take a look at the Kickstarter page. But as always, I have to put the disclaimer here. This is a crowdfunding campaign and not a direct purchase, so please read the fine print. I will get some of these for my sets for sure. Please let me know your thoughts in the comments. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. I suggest to subscribe with notifications, as exciting new LEGO videos are coming soon. See you next time, bye bye.